In this video, I'm going to use a web application to demonstrate the standard error of the beta values in a linear model. This is not my web app. This is something that someone else wrote, and I'll link to it at the end of the tutorial, but it is very good for illustrating what the standard error around a beta value is. So first of all, I'm just going to set up the population data by clicking this button. So essentially what this is doing is it's creating a population of data that involves two random variables that have a set kind of relationship. And the relationship between those variables is expressed down here as a linear model. So we're predicting the outcome y from a predictor variable x, and the beta zero or intercept is one, and the beta one or the gradient is two. So that's the kind of true the true parameters are one and two, and we're going to focus on the gradient, so the two in that equation. So the question is, what happens when we take random samples and try to estimate these parameters? So this button here is going to take a random sample from that population and show us what it looks like. So the graph on the left shows us the data that have been sampled as well as the population. So the population data are shown as a kind of gray circles, and any one of those circles that has been sampled is highlighted in red. So you can see there are fewer red circles than there are gray ones because the sample is smaller than the population. So in the sample, the blue line shows us the line of best fit, and we can see, for example, that the gradient of that line is 1.7. So the true value is 2. The value we've got in our sample is 1.7. So what happens when we take another random sample? Well, again, it's now sampled different values from the population. It's estimated the parameters of that linear model, and again, it's got a value of 1.7 for the beta 1. And now on the right hand side, we can start to see basically a histogram of the different beta values that we're getting from our samples. So if we take another sample, this time, again, we've sampled different data, we've got a different line of best fit, and this time the beta 1 that we get is 2.4, so it's overestimated the true value. And you can see now on the histogram on the right, we've got a value for 2.4 emerging as a bar with a count of 1. Let's pick another random sample. Again, different data points have been sampled, we get a different line of best fit, and this time the beta 1 is a value of 1.2. And again, that's now shown up on our histogram. So our histogram is gradually building up more and more values as we take more samples. So let's take another sample. This time we get a beta value of 0.86. And again, our histogram of betas from our samples is building up. So let's speed this up a bit and start taking lots of samples. The thing to note here is on the left, each sample we take is slightly different from the last. We're getting different lines, we're getting different slopes of those lines, which means we're getting different estimates of beta 1. And each time we take a sample, our histogram on the right hand side is getting more populated because we have more samples and therefore more estimates of B. So right, let's go crazy. Let's get RSI in my mouse clicking finger and go bonkers. Taking more and more samples, we're getting more and more estimates of beta, and you can see as we get more and more and more and more of these, our histogram that's plotting the values of betas from our samples is starting to look more and more like a normal distribution. This is quite fun doing all this clicking. Obviously, I'm lying. It's not. It's tedious. But this is just illustrating now. We're getting hundreds and hundreds of samples. La 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 la. You can go make some tea at this point if you want. It doesn't really get any more interesting. I'm just going to sit here clicking. I might just go walk the dog while I'm kind of waiting for this to go on. Which I know what you're thinking now. You're thinking, how am I going to keep clicking the button if I'm walking the dog? But it's a little known fact that my arms are like Mr. Tickles. They're extremely long, extremely stretchy. So I can, in fact, take the dog around the park. My arms will just stretch in here, up into my house, up to my computer, and keep clicking away so you can see all these samples being generated. So, you know, I'll be off and see you in a bit. I'm back from the dog walk. The dog was not impressed. He said it was a very short walk. He said, frankly, he wants a walk where I'm not running some kind of weird sampling demonstration at the same time and I have to get back to finish it. He said he'd like a proper walk where, you know, I throw balls and he gets to fetch them and that sort of thing. So I've promised him one tomorrow morning and hopefully we'll see how that goes. I feel like I'm taking tedium to kind of new depths that no one's ever been to before with this demonstration. So hopefully, anyway, what you can see here is as you take different samples, you get different estimates of the regression parameters or the linear model parameters, and they have a distribution. So some samples will give us B values very, very close to the true value. Remember, the true value was 2. So some of our samples have given us estimates close to 2, and some of our samples have given us estimates quite far from 2. So if you look on the graph on the right-hand side, some of them have given us estimates of 0 even, and or close to 0, and other ones have given us estimates as large as, say, 3.5. So your sample estimate is not always exactly what the true value is. And the sampling distribution tells us something about the variation in sample estimates. So if that distribution is very, very wide, then it tells us something about, it basically says that there's going to be a lot of variability in the estimates you get across samples, whereas if it's very narrow, it means that there's not going to be a lot of variability across your samples. And the standard deviation of this distribution is the standard error. So the standard error, if it's small, means you've got a narrow sampling distribution, and it means that the betas, the estimates of beta that you get, do not vary too much across different samples. Whereas if you have a large standard error, kind of means the opposite, which is that the estimates of beta that you're going to get across samples are going to vary quite widely.